Welcome to ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by Hampton Hotels and the Wild and Woolly SEC on ESPN. You are looking live at Faurot Field in Columbia, Missouri. It is senior day here at Mizzou, and what a season these seniors have had. The Tigers are a win away from playing Auburn for an SEC championship. But standing in their way tonight is Johnny Football, Johnny Manziel, and the Texas A&M Aggies. And these fans, as you can see, came prepared with signs, "We want Bama." But hold on, everybody. In a shocking turnaround, two touchdowns in the last 32 seconds, Auburn wins the West, and they will play either Missouri or South Carolina next week in Atlanta. Good evening, everybody. Welcome with Kirk Herbstreit. Folks, just like you, we're shaking our head at what happened down in Auburn, Alabama. BCS chaos, my friend.
Where do you even begin to talk about what just happened? I think the whole nation right now is just flabbergasted by the turn of events down at the Iron Bowl. Auburn with a big win. They get to Atlanta, and now we find out if Missouri tonight has what it takes. They are 60 minutes away from shocking the SEC and also gaining a trip to get to the SEC title.
Yeah, and what about the Mizzou Tigers here tonight, Herbie?
Well, I think it has a lot to do with just consistency. Last year, they had a lot of injuries. This year, James Franklin has battled through some injuries, but he understands this offense. He's been around now for 4 years, understands the checks, understands everything that he needs to do in running this very balanced attack. And let's face it, A&M has struggled with a young defense. He's going to try to run the football and then see if he can find some matchups downfield for some big plays in a pass game.
Well, Herbie mentioned it, and there are the numbers, folks. The Aggie defense has certainly struggled in the SEC, and the Tiger offense, well, they have flowered even with a backup quarterback for four games. But on the other side, Johnny Football.
That's all you have to say is Johnny Football. And Johnny Football would tell you that last week was one of his most disappointing games that he's quarterback since he's been at Texas A&M. He was frustrated. The entire offense was frustrated. He's got a different feel to him tonight. Seeing him down on the field before the games, he's got that swagger back. I think LSU did a great job in defending Johnny. And what they did is, with great defensive ends, instead of getting upfield, Brent, they kind of throttled that pass rush down and just kind of kept him in the pocket. Try to make him make plays from the pocket and then beat up his wide receivers. So if you can disrupt the timing, you have a chance to slow him down. That's exactly what Missouri will try to do tonight with their talented front four. Not necessarily get upfield, but try to corral the most talented, arguably the most talented quarterback in the country.
Well, Manziel is now coming out with his Aggie teammates here in Faurot Field. Beautiful night for football. Sellout crowd. The kickoff is next. Who will play Auburn for an SEC championship? Can you believe what I just said? That's right. Auburn awaits either Missouri or South Carolina.
ESPN College Football Primetime. Brought to you by Tostitos Cantina Chips. Real restaurant taste wherever your party's at. Bose new Quiet Comfort 20 headphones. Better sound. And Dr. Pepper. Always one of a kind.
Johnny Manziel.
He fumbled the ball. He got it back. Wide open. Touchdown. Touchdown. He just scored.
It's just not fair.
Johnny Football just did it again. That's another one of those wow plays.
Now he's running for his life, and he's going to throw it up for grabs.
Oh, it's a catch on a Hail Mary.
Wow. Talk about the magic of Johnny Manziel.
Yeah, you talk about magic, but against Auburn, he appeared to injure the throwing thumb. All right, and for more on that story, let's go to Heather Cox. Heather?
Yeah, Brent, Johnny Manziel admitted that that thumb is quite bothersome, and I can tell you it is definitely swollen. Now, he originally injured it against Auburn when he was throwing. That thumbprint area of his thumb actually hit his lineman's helmet. He then re-injured it last week in preparing for LSU. Coach Sumlin told me he's having trouble even brushing his teeth or buttoning his shirt. And medical personnel told me that thumb, definitely the worst finger to injure, because you lose that finite control control, and then you compensate by trying to throw it harder. And guys, Manziel knows he needs to play better. Last week, in the tunnel immediately following that LSU loss, he told his private quarterback coach, "I didn't get it done. If I don't get it done, we don't get it done. I need to play better." We'll see how that thumb affects that goal tonight, guys.
And there is Kevin Sumlin. Folks, he's buying dinner for everybody tonight. 6-year extension he agreed to coach the Texas A&M Aggies. Remember all of those reports about USC going to come a-knocking? And there were some folks who thought Houston of the NFL might drive on down there and talk to him, but you can forget about it. The one thing the Aggies have got in abundance is money, and they came up with it, and Kevin has agreed to a 6-year extension. The Aggies won the toss, and they will receive. So Trey Williams goes back deep along with Molina. So we will see Johnny Manziel right at the start of this game.
With the way this day has gone, Brent, we're in store for, you got to think, some fireworks here tonight.
Win and Missouri's in. Lose and South Carolina's in. Short kickoff. And Manziel will come to work at the 35-yard line with the first play of the game. And, you know, one of the things that you can say about Johnny Manziel, Herbie, I think you certainly agree with me, he's the most exciting player in college football.
No doubt about it. You just never know what you can expect from him. And after the game that he and his offense played last week against LSU, I think they're just anxious to get back out on the field. And there are a lot of people that believe this will be the last game for Johnny Manziel as far as the regular season is concerned. And I think he's anxious to go out and play very well.
We expect to see the Aggies attempt to run the game, as Herb reported, and Molina is the ball carrier on first down, struggling to get back to the line of scrimmage. And Herbie, let's take a look at tonight's impact players, brought to you by Chick-fil-A.
Well, they definitely need to be able to run the football with Ben Molina and a group of talented backs, but they've got to do a better job up front. Mike Evans, of course, on the outside. Andrew Wilson will be there when they run the ball, and then E.J. Gaines, 31, will be lined up one-on-one, especially with Mike Evans quite a bit. It'll be a great matchup to watch.
Second and 10, Manziel keeps it himself. And he runs for about 4 yards, and Brothers makes the stop.
Very active front seven. If you've not seen Missouri play, they have one of the most talented and deepest front fours in college football. It's led them to a great year this year in the SEC, and it frees up their linebackers like Brothers, Wilson, and Bonner to make a lot of plays in the run game.
Needs 6 yards, laterals it out, not going to get it. It's three and out on their first series. Brothers again, and note that Manziel did not even attempt to take it downfield on their first series.
Yeah, man coverage on the outside, and they go with an option, and to get the option going against man coverage, you get the pitch, but you got to be able to have some blocks out on the outside. That time they just collapsed down on the runner.
Marcus Murphy, number 6, the all-everything returner for Mizzou, is back deep. There's a penalty flag. The ball is down at the 1 yard line, but hold on, because back by the punter. That's Drew Kayser. He's out of Strongsville, Ohio. He's a sophomore punter, and he's the young man who was hit.
Missouri's defense does their job against Manziel with a three and out, but this would be a big mistake for the special teams.
Defense, number 21. The penalty is 5 yards. Repeat fourth down.
Fortunate that they didn't get a personal foul here, and they just got to running into the punter.
If I'm the Aggies, I'm declining this. Didn't want it down to about the 1 yard line down here. I don't take this penalty. Or do they have an option on it?
Well, I'm still trying to figure out how that's running into the punter. he got trucked.
It was 4th and 6.
Johnny Manziel's coming back out of the field.
So fourth and short, that's what they wanted to do.
Sure.
They wanted to go on fourth and short. So it makes it fourth and one. And they come with the big back. And he appeared to get the first down. On his first carry of the game, Trey Carson, who's been injured, comes in. He's 230 pounds, and that's his first carry. He didn't play at all last week. And Trey Carson, who formerly was up at Oregon, picks up the first down for Sumlin.
Four plays and four running plays. Look for Manziel to try to get the ball thrown out to the outside against this defense.
Now Trey Williams, the sophomore running back, number three, checks in along with Manziel. Also in that backfield is Cameron Clear, the tight end, works as an H-back back there. Out into the left flat, using a running back for the first time, and Williams gets back to the original line of scrimmage. Wilson, the very active middle linebacker for the Tigers, with the snap.
Boy, Brent, it's just amazing to watch this defense leverage the football. Here's a ball thrown out into the flat, a little fake to the right, comes back. Look at how they get off blocks. There's four or five black jerseys. They keep everything in front of them, and then they rally to the football. They've been doing it all year.
Second down and nine for Manziel. Very good thrower back. He goes to the screen again and still short of the first down on that second and nine. Williams
trying to challenge the discipline of this defense. Looks like Kentrell Brothers is injured and got to the sideline, but there's another Missouri player down. It could be Shane Ray, one of the defensive ends. So a couple Tigers on that play, a little bit banged up.
They use about six or seven of those defensive linemen that you talked about. Coach Steckel rotates him in and out, and of course Michael Sam has had an All-American kind of year. If you want to keep an eye on him, folks, he's number 52. Cody Ely on the other side, number 47. They'll use him at tackle and also at defensive end.
Shane Ray was involved in that play along with Brothers. Pretty physical. You see running into one another is what sent Ray to the sideline.
So here comes third down and five for Manziel and the Aggies. Got four receivers out wide, two to each side of the offensive line. Looking to go downfield for the first time, short and incomplete. Walker, number 11, the intended receiver, but note that that ball was well short of the receiver.
I think if you're Texas A&M, you're an A&M fan watching this game, the reason it's important that they start fast is because of how the game went last week. If A&M's going to compete tonight, Johnny Manziel and this offense needs to find its confidence that it missed after the way they played last week in Baton Rouge.
So Marcus Murphy will try it again. He was standing back there. Of course, the penalty was called. And he makes the fair catch at the 10-yard line. And that's where Mizzou and quarterback James Franklin will go to work when you come back to Columbia.
Visit WatchESPN.com or download the Watch ESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Scoreless here, just underway. If Missouri wins, they will play Auburn next Saturday in Atlanta for an SEC championship. And who saw that coming? When you go back and look at those preseason magazines in August, as I did this week, Herbie, nobody had them challenging for the title of these. But here they are, and here's James Franklin.
And what a great job that Gary Finkel's done this year with this team. But, boy, you got to think Gus Malzahn's going to be up for most of the National Coach of the Year awards.
Henry Josey is the very durable running back off that major knee injury a couple of seasons ago. He gets the first call here for Mizzou. Stansberry, who was questionable tonight, wearing number 90, makes the first stop. So he is playing, even though they do not have one of their very talented wide receivers. Malcolm Kennedy will not be able to go for the Aggies.
Yeah, Stansberry playing with an ankle. They're going to try to see how long he can go out there. They've got some other injuries up front. They're trying to do the best they can. Playing a lot of true freshmen tonight.
Second down and eight. Franklin, a little bit short of the receiver, and that was Doriel Green Beckham.
What a great group of wide receivers that they have here. Not only do you have Dorial Green-Beckham, but also LaDainian Washington, more of a vertical threat. Henry Josie's really where this thing starts. They average 238 yards a game on the ground. And for an A&M defense that's been much maligned, Steven Jenkins has got to be active against the run. And also Devontae Harris has got to hold up in one-on-one coverage on the outside along with Everett.
Third down and 8. Franklin in trouble, escapes the pressure. Short of the first down, and Mizzou three and out on their first series.
Well, one thing Mark Snyder wants to do when he gets this offense to third down is get creative with the pressure. You see how they're showing pressure, and as the ball is snapped, they drop, and then they come right up the middle. I think they confused Missouri up front. Evan Bayham that time just a little bit slow to react off to the snap because of the quickness. They timed that blitz up perfectly, and you'll see a lot of that from A&M on third down is mixing up their looks and being multiple.
Harris is deep to return this punt. Standing at the Aggie 40-yard line. Takes a bounce and he picks it up, and he killed it. When he waves his hands like that, that kills it. You saw that today earlier in the Alabama-Auburn game. We had it a week ago in the Oklahoma State-Baylor game. Waving the arms like that, an invalid fair catch signal. Ball is dead. Timeout.
ESPN College Football Primetime is presented by Hampton Hotels. Feel the Hamptonality. And in part by Ford. You could win a new F-150 and a trip for two to four BCS bowl games at Ford.com/BCS.
Head coach Gary Pinkel and the Missouri football team enjoying their Thanksgiving dinner here Thursday night in Columbia. Now Brandon Williams. So this is the fourth running back used by the Aggies already, and this is just their second series. Manziel's going to run over behind him on the left side, scrambled for a couple of yards, brought down by Ely.
Kind of the game within the game tonight. When Johnny Manziel looks into a defense, he's looking at the safeties and he's looking at the outside linebackers and he's counting numbers. If the numbers commit to the line of scrimmage, they'll throw it. If in this case they're sitting back, then a lot of times they'll have to be able to run it. That time both safeties were back and they ran the football.
Second down and the handoff, and barging out is Brandon Williams, the transfer from Oklahoma. He has sort of disappeared from this offense the last few weeks, but this is a good run.
Yeah, and they're going to have to run the ball. They're the first one to admit last week they may have jumped the gun and thrown the ball a little bit too much early.
And they're going to come right back with Williams.
He's excited.
Spring, Texas, you bet. Brothers is there with Wilson.
Yeah, it's been Molina and Trey Williams. Brandon Williams getting his chance right now. And running the football just is so important to Manziel to take some of the pressure off of him in the passing game. Again, especially after the way they performed last week.
And that time he delivered a strike to the outside and Travis Labard. Travis Labard is one of those great stories. He was cut by the basketball team, so he went over to the women's basketball team and was on the practice team that got them ready and walked onto the football team. And here he is, a very active receiver. And Williams, short of that first down. But Travis Labard told high school coach, he said, you know, you're a good enough football player. Why don't you walk on? And here he is tonight. And, of course, with Kennedy out, he steps up. Bigger role. Third down and one now. Very close to the first down. You can see the spot there. The line judge moving from that sideline. Looks like he's giving it to him. The umpire, they spot the ball.
Yeah, a great battle to watch is the battle in the trenches. Again, this is a Texas A&M offensive line that over the year has shown an ability to run the football. I think in the middle with Matthews and Ifedy, they struggle from times getting a push, but it's an essential part of what they do because they find a rhythm with Manziel and those quick passes when they are able to run.
Trey Carson, now the Aggie running back. One of four used here tonight. Manziel throws back to Mike Evans. First catch of the night for the big 6'5" sophomore from Galveston. He certainly is a finalist for the Biletnikoff Award. one of the better wide receivers, Irby, that you and I have watched, especially in that game back in September against Alabama.
Yes.
What a day he had.
And he has improved so much. You and I called one of his first games last year against Florida. Think about how far he has come through reps and just hard work to become one of the elite receivers in the country.
Second down and 9. Manziel fires another strike and got a first down. Labhart again.
There's that cushion. And if you're going to give Labhart the cushion, Johnny Manziel is going to dial that up. See that cushion? He's going to take that. That's an extension of the running game for A&M.
On the first down, pitching it out to the outside.
Gonzalez has great quickness. Again, it's about getting the ball out there. Gonzalez is one of the quicker players on the perimeter. He's a true freshman that's emerged here in the latter part of the season this year.
First down and 10. The Aggies have driven to the Mizzou 29-yard line on their second possession. Breaking free. 10, 5, touchdown Aggies. Trey Carson strikes first.
Well, that's Texas A&M football right there. That's a 10-play drive, mixing in the run with the pass. Couple different backs got in there. Brandon Williams got it started, brought in energy. Trey Carson got a chance, but Johnny Manziel making great decisions, throwing the football, spreading them out, and then running up the middle and mixing up the play calling. That again, that's a Texas A&M drive that they love, and that could maybe get this offense started.
Josh Lambeau tacks on the extra point. Connor McQueen is the new holder for the Aggies here today. And it's 7-0 after that 29-yard touchdown run by Trey Carson. Aggies strike first. Very punishing ground game so far.
It sure was, and I think the attention from completing some passes got the defense's attention. Watch the defensive backs, because Johnny goes 4 for 4 on this drive, and all of a sudden you show the same action. Look at this. Look at the defense. All of a sudden the defensive backs are occupied, and now you break an arm tackle, and look at the running lane here for Carson. He gets off of Sam, one of the better defensive ends in the SEC. He breaks that arm tackle, and he's in the open area there, and it has everything to do with the balanced attack and Manziel throwing those quick throws to get those defensive backs' attention.
Now Murphy back deep to return this kick from Missouri. Out of the end zone. He'll come on the 25. Let's check in with Reese Davis for our first update of the night. Reese.
All right, Brent, time for Sports Center right now, presented by Ally Bank. And the story of the day, number one Alabama goes down in most improbable fashion when Chris Davis, name like that, you got speed, returns a missed field goal more than 100 yards on the final snap of the game. And Auburn wins it 34-28 and puts itself right in the middle of the national championship conversation.
Absolutely, Reese, and it was interesting. The officials put 1 second back on the clock, and Alabama opted to attempt that long field goal. And now Hansbrough is in as the running back from Missouri. He gets the first call here, and he is thrown down at the line of scrimmage there, and that was Claiborne making the stop.
Yes, sir, the true freshman who has really emerged for Mark Snyder's defense. It's been a step or two forward, a step or two back for this young defense, and he's got to be able to play big tonight for the Aggies defense.
Second down and 9. There's Claiborne eyeing the set here. See what James Franklin, the senior, is going to come up with. Takes off on the move again. First down and more. Out near that 45-yard line.
What a block. Once he got out of the way of the pressure, watch the great receiver right there, Doriel Green Beckham, with a big block there to spring him loose and get him that much further down the field to be able to pick up more yards. But there's the experience of Franklin and getting away from the trouble.
18-yard gain, and they come back on the ground behind this very, very aggressive, talented offensive line Justin Britt and Max Copeland are on the left side. Evan Bame is the center. Connor McGovern and Mitch Morris operate on the right side. And if you want to look for one of the keys for Missouri this year, it's right there, the big fellas on the offensive line.
It's nice when they stay healthy, isn't it?
Isn't it? Last year they had to mix and match year long.
What a difference you get in the SEC. Continuity up front.
Franklin from the pocket. And a nice catch over there. Under heavy coverage that time by Devontae Harris. And that's Green Beckham making the catch.
6-6 now. This is a matchup all night to watch. We talked about him in our players to watch tonight, the impact players. Pretty good coverage, but he's 5'11 going up a receiver against a receiver who's 6'6. And I'll tell you, Green Beckham does an outstanding job of using his body to position himself away from the defender and to the football.
And Mizzou comes right back with that running game. Stansberry making the stop on Hansbrough.
Much like what A&M did on their last drive, now Missouri with James Franklin getting into a flow here offensively, mixing up their play calling and kind of getting A&M back on their heels.
Josie with the option. Franklin keeps it. And he's short of that first down marker. Third down here coming up for the Tigers.
This Missouri offense, when they run the football, whether it's the option play or the outside zone play, they're all about stretching the defense horizontally. They want to get to the perimeter, get outside, and then find a crease and hit it and get upfield. That time, the Aggies were there just enough there just to be able to stop him short of a first down.
Checking the sideline for the play call. Josh Henson, the new offensive coordinator this season for the Tigers. Franklin has time, snaps it off for the first down, goes right back to Green Beckham again. Green Beckham very, very active here tonight already.
The big fella, right? Third down, we're in the red zone. One guy I'm going to look up is a receiver at 6'6".
You know, Herbie, he's not the only tall fella out there. Washington goes 6'4", White goes 6'3". He's a big, look at those big wide receivers spread the field.
Intramural basketball team, these guys listening?
Is Josie.
There are a bunch of small forwards out there.
Indeed. Robinson with the snap for the Aggies.
Henry Josie gets most of the carries, but we'll see Russell Hansbrough tonight. Marcus Murphy, all three backs, very similar in their attributes. Low center of gravity, great quickness, able to kind of hide in that backfield and then accelerate upfield.
Josie, the other side of that, he's only 5'10", but very talented young man, and here he is. And he had his wheels cut out after picking up a couple of yards. And that was a good tackle that time. Hall, freshman, number 10. There's some talented youngsters on this Aggie defense, but they're short of experience, and that has certainly shown this season.
Yeah, and here's this third down. Remember, they had success earlier in the last series on a third down. They want to try to get creative with their pressures, try to confuse a veteran offensive line and a veteran quarterback. And they come again. Right guard.
Right guard moved, McGovern. And that was McGovern. He's out of Fargo, North Dakota.
False start. Offense, number 60. 5-yard penalty. It remains third down.
And that makes it a lot tougher here.
That's a little thing, but it's the pre-snap movement and the different calls that are being made up front to react to that movement that a lot of times can cause an offensive lineman to just jump. He's so concerned about what he's seeing from the defense and how they're jumping around and moving that all of a sudden he might just kind of blow a fuse there and it cost him 5 yards.
Now they need 13 yards. Firing down the middle, incomplete.
They mixed it up. They've been bringing pressure, but after that 5-yard penalty, they dropped eight into coverage. Try to get after James Franklin with three and then put eight in coverage, and I think they did a nice job of getting just enough pressure there and then confusing the quarterback, and he threw that football right into coverage there.
So Prinzer will punt. Missouri has handled the ball twice here against the Aggies, and both times they have punted away. Fair catch down by the 1-yard line by Harris. And that's where Johnny Manziel and the Aggies will go to work when you come back. Yes, it's a beautiful night in Columbia. But they trail 7-0. Kirby, eight fellas have touched the ball for the Aggies so far.
Yeah, and they did just such a great job the last time they had the football. Again, it was vintage Johnny Manziel. Some quick throws. Nothing downfield. He was 4-4 for just 16 yards, but he caught the defense's attention, made them really respect that, and then it opened up the running game with Trey Carson. He breaks that tackle into the open field and gets into the end zone.
Day three of 25 games. And, of course, in that 2013 Rice game, Johnny Manziel did not play the first half, you might recall. But now first down and 10. He is standing on his own goal line here. Backs up in his end zone. Couldn't find an open receiver. And here's where he's dangerous on the move. Picks up about 3 or 4 yards. Scrambling out to the right. As Herbie pointed out at the top of the broadcast, that's basically what LSU took away from Manziel last week.
Yes, sir. They did a great job of just kind of corralling him. And I think an adjustment from A&M, with Abuhi on the right side and Matthews on the left, is when Johnny does drop back, if you can seal that defensive end to the inside, it opens up more of a lane to the outside to be able to break contain.
Molina, the running back, behind the right side. Second effort, and he is still almost 2 yards shy. Bonner, the first, the Sam linebacker, come up and hit the running back.
It's early in this game, but it's a very different looking A&M offense from what we saw a week ago. Some of that obviously was LSU, and a lot of it was also A&M themselves. They have more yards in this first quarter than they had the entire second half last week against LSU.
Third and one. Aggies committed to the run tonight. And this time he's going to throw that short pass, and he's got the first down. So three different receivers, and Labhart has been one of the most active. They're shorthanded without Kennedy. Evans has caught one. Gonzalez has caught one.
And he came into this game in the last six games with 34 receptions. So in the second half of this season, he's been a go-to guy.
Manziel off play action goes to the far side, and another completion. And about an 8-yard gain on first down. Gonzalez again.
He sees the soft coverage. If you give him soft coverage, he's going to take it. And again, it's an extension of that running game. You get the ball out to the outside. Gonzalez has a different kind of burst when he catches those quick throws like that.
Second and two. Box play, and Manziel close to that first down marker.
This is a Missouri defense that has been terrific this year. They lead the SEC in interceptions. They lead the SEC in sacks, tackles for a loss. Been outstanding up front. In this first quarter, you got to give A&M a lot of credit for being able to keep them off balance a bit.
Mike Matthews is the center. His brother Jake Matthews over left tackle. Probably the top-rated left tackle in the country this year. Off play action, Manziel gonna go deep down the middle, and incomplete. There was terrific coverage by EJ Gaines. Remember now, Gaines is gonna go one-on-one tonight with Evans. Watch this duel.
Yeah, interesting call here, Brent. It's third and just about a yard, and they decide to go for the home run. They try to get the another true freshman, Jaquay Williams, behind coverage. So instead of dinking it and getting the first down, they go for the big one.
So Murphy's back deep to the end of the first quarter. We'll try to return this one. Makes the first man miss. Out to the 26-yard line. 7-0. And the Aggies with the lead, and there's a flag around midfield that was thrown on this play. Referee tonight is Ken Williamson of the SEC.
After the play was over, personal foul, receiving team number 81. The penalty is half the distance to the goal. It'll be first down.
Looks like Hicks over there on that far side. We'll check that. So the end of the first quarter. The Aggies lead it by a touchdown. Welcome back to ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by Hampton Hotels and the SEC on ESPN. Auburn will play for the SEC Championship in Atlanta, and who will they meet? If Missouri beats Texas A&M, they will go to Atlanta. If Missouri loses tonight, South Carolina will go, regardless of how they do tonight against Clemson. Marcus Murphy checks in as the running back with Manziel watching from the sideline. Quick first quarter. Irby pointed out during that commercial break, both teams running the ball. Here's Franklin. And again, this is about the third time Herbie couldn't find a receiver and has to try to dance out of trouble.
No, and again, this is a defense that has struggled in this area, but they're doing a good job of mixing up their looks. They're mixing in their personnel. They're staying multiple, which is a big goal of theirs tonight. And when you can hold up with those receivers, it allows that rush to eventually get in there and apply the pressure. Remember, Franklin, a veteran quarterback.
And the longer Missouri goes trailing, the more pressure will be on the Tigers because of that goal that's out there. There, he dumps it off underneath. And running back that time, Marcus Murphy caught the ball.
I don't know about you, Brent, but we're only a quarter in. But they feel a little bit tight. They're a little flat here a first quarter in. They just don't look like the team that we've been watching. And I don't know if that's feeling that pressure that you're talking about. They're 60 minutes away from getting to Atlanta. Or if they've just come out a little bit flat to start this game.
Yeah, I agree with you, Herbie. You know, they've won 10 games by 14 or more points, so they can be explosive. Franklin incomplete, and that time he had Green Beckham on the slant and missed him.
And again, this is going to be tight coverage on third down. They know what they have to do. DeShazer Everett, one of the better players on this defense. Ball is just out in front of Green Beckham. Really didn't have a chance to come up with it. But Everett and Harris, we said at the beginning of the broadcast, they're going to be left on islands a lot. And when they are, they've got to hold up against a much taller group of wide receivers.
This figures to be good field position for Manziel and the Aggies. Harris is standing on the Texas A&M 41-yard line. Low returnable kick. Harris, the second man, won't fumble. Loose ball. Mizzou jumps on it. Harris attempting to return the punt after making what the coaches thought was a poor fair catch at the 5-yard line. Now fumbles the ball, and Mizzou has its first big opportunity of the game on this turnover right here, Herbie.
Yes, sir. Harris is trying to keep the play alive, and obviously he's unable to. That time, Stewart knocks that ball loose. Great effort to be able to pounce on it by Missouri. But let's remember, Missouri is coming into this game plus 14 in turnover margin. That's sixth in the country, and they needed something to kind of spark them to get them going, and maybe this turnover will be the thing that they needed.
42 consecutive games, longest active streak in FBS, with a turnover that is forced. And now Matty Mock checks in for the first time. Remember, the coaches told us that Matty Mock would get a series. He replaced the injured Franklin, who was out with a separated shoulder for 4 games. And all Matty Mock did was go 3-1 as a starter. So from the gun, Matty Mock, a dangerous athlete, dances out of trouble, moving to his left. And he's going to take a loss on the first down. Kirby, tell us about Matty Mock, because, of course, he played high school back in Kenton, Ohio.
Yeah, his dad, he played for in high school at Kenton. His brother, Ben, also went to Wake Forest, transferred to Cincinnati. Just a kind of a gym rat, a guy that can throw the ball well. He'll be a great star down the road here. Also much more mobile and quicker than James Franklin. And he's got a kind of a gunslinger mentality for a young player.
Facing a 2nd and 16 after that 6-yard loss. And the big story of the night, the performance of the Aggie defense so far. They have done a remarkable job. That is, slips it to the outside. Jimmy Hunt, receiver over. That's good down below, now to Heather.
Well, Herbie was talking about how athletic Matty Mock was, the way he really helped his team this week. He spent a ton of time on the scout team doing his best Johnny Manziel imitation. Coach Pinkel said he's the best athlete for the job. He gave us a great look, scrambling around, holding the ball out, helping the defense try to learn to swat it away, and really helped this Mizzou defense against Manziel.
So it's 3rd and 11 for Matty. Has plenty of time. Can't find an open receiver. Now he dances off to the right. He's going to try to throw it down that sideline. Incomplete. Green Beckham. The target was working the near side, and it is fourth down. Howard Matthews with coverage that time.
Again, only rushing three and dropping eight on third down and long. Right now, Mark Snyder, the defensive coordinator from Texas A&M, has got to be very pleased with the way his defense is playing. Third down especially. Missouri only 1 of 5 early in this game on third down, and I continue to go back to the multiple looks that A&M is giving this offense.
Harris is right back there. And he waves everybody away. Remember, he made the fair catch back at the 5-yard line. And Kevin Sumlin talked to him on the sideline and said, son, we don't do that.
I can do it from up here.
Close to this one. Timeout. Kirby, look who followed you from Auburn all the way to Columbia.
Oh, here we go.
Flack.
All right, go. The first reigning Heisman Trophy winner to play at Faurot Field last 34 years. Who was the last Heisman Trophy winner to visit Faurot Field? Give that a little thought there.
34 though. Years, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
You're just a young one. Trey Williams is the running back here for Manziel and the Aggies. Here comes Trey trying to dance the daylight. He's going to give up some ground. Gave up a couple of yards that time. Brothers in on that tackle, the first to hit him.
We wondered if the turnover might ignite Missouri, and A&M's defense stepped up big to be able to get the ball back to Manziel. But again, you kind of still have that feeling. Now, Missouri's defense has played well all year. Can they do something to try to get this stadium and this team to come alive?
Manziel has thrown 9 passes, completed 7 for 32 yards. He's averaging a little under 4 yards a pass because of that injured throwing thumb. There's a penalty flag down. On this run, there is a penalty flag. In fact, there's a couple of them back there that were thrown.
A little bit of trash talking down there, too.
Holding offense, number 75. The penalty is half the distance to the goal. Repeat, second down.
That's big Jake Matthews, the left tackle.
We all agree he's one of the better left tackles. You mentioned that earlier, Brent. But he's also going up against some of the better defensive ends that he's faced all year. It was right towards the end once he wrapped him up with Ely there when they called it.
You know, Herbie, we are told that Manziel came into this game averaging about 10 yards an attempt. So there is no question that his throwing hand has been hampered, and the Aggies are relying on a run as we take a timeout here in the second quarter.
ESPN College Football Primetime, brought to you by the Discover It card. It's a game changer. And The Hobbit, The Desolation of Smaug, in theaters everywhere December 13th.
Columbia, Missouri. And a beaten up Johnny Manziel facing a 2nd and 16 after that vicious hit. Came in with an injured throwing thumb. And now he's backed up in his own end zone. And a throw out of it. Can't find a receiver. And he'll take this one out of bounds at about the 10-yard line. And that was E.J. Gaines, the veteran corner and one of the captains of this Missouri team and one of the good ones here.
We were at that break. A&M called that timeout because Johnny was a little woozy there. I don't know if it was his head or possibly a leg. Of course, that right hand also affecting him. But you and I have done quite a few of his games. One of the more competitive players in college football. And if this is his last game in a regular season, it's going to take a lot to get him out of this game.
3rd and 12. Got it on the break, Walker. Beautiful throw. Walker takes it to the 34-yard line for a first down.
Great timing, and give the offensive line a lot of credit here for being able to give Johnny the amount of time that he needs. You could see the safety there sat to the outside. It opened up that big lane.
Aggies quickly come back after that first down with a running play and not much doing there. The defense was ready for it. That was Donovan Bonner, the linebacker, again.
And remember, this defense has been tremendous this year at affecting quarterbacks. And Dave Steckel, one of the better defensive coordinators you'll find, very, very aggressive with his mindset. Even though he plays a lot of zone, They get exotic. They get crazy because of the talent that they have up front. But up to this point, A&M's offensive line and the play calling, I think, from A&M doing a good job of offsetting that.
Second and eight. Far side complete. Evans reaches for that first down. Gaines was on him, and Mike Evans, with a little bit of cushion, made the most of it.
Yep, that's the thing. Johnny's looking for that cushion. He sees one safety in the middle of the field. He knows that he's got to find a receiver. Why not go to his favorite target, who's matched up against an all-conference corner in E.J. Gaines?
On the move now, throwing back to the middle, and this time he's got Labhart again. Labhart has been his favorite target here tonight, and they barge into Mizzou territory.
First time they've had success going backside. They've hit so much to the play side, you can see the defense is anticipating play side, and they snuck Labhart in from behind.
Now Manziel, 10 to 12. This is what he can do. Double back, coming to the left. Eddie will throw this one away. One of the more dangerous quarterbacks, Herbie, we've seen coming to the left as a right-handed quarterback. That's a tough throw, but he seems to get the shoulders square at the right time.
He sure does. You know, he's worked very hard on that, and I think that's the thing that people misinterpret and don't really understand, is how hard a worker Johnny Manziel is, especially with some of the off-season stories and the things that people kind of bought into. They don't realize what a grinder he is when it comes to the fundamentals of playing this position.
Now on second and 10, Manziel covered, going to take off behind the running back, and nothing doing. Gives up a yard on that play. Matt Hope for 89, the first hitting.
But we saw LSU kind of corral him. That's how you defend Manziel, because he's so dangerous improvising and creating. You don't want to necessarily get upfield and give him lanes to step into. You want to just kind of corral him, kind of squeeze him into that pocket. His longest run tonight is 5 yards. They're doing a very good job of not at least giving up those big plays.
Facing a third and 12. Four wide receivers. Three are to the right of the field side right now. Manziel pulls it back. Offensive line gives him time. Now he'll be forced to throw a jump ball. Incomplete. And that coverage over there by that defensive back, they had pressure. Ely, first of all, was on top of him. And then Simon had the coverage.
They had a spy in coverage, but this was what LSU did. They had great coverage on the perimeter along with a great pass rush. Look at Mike Evans. He has nowhere to go. They've got him taken out, and eventually the big fella, Ely, gets the pressure. But give the credit there to the coverage downfield by the Tigers defense.
Kaiser to punt it away for the Aggies. Murphy with the fair catch at the 6-yard line. And that's where Mizzou will have it. 8:33 remaining in a defensive struggle. 7-0 Aggies.
For all the points.
Time's up, Herbie. Affleck said, who was the last reigning Heisman Trophy winner to play at Ferrell Field?
I'm going to go Mike Rozier.
Good guess.
Old school running back.
It's old school, but there it is. Billy Sims.
Billy Sims.
Oh, is he sweet.
What are you doing? How about that dude? You see him?
Man.
Oh, number 20 now.
One of my first memories, Ohio State, Oklahoma at the Horseshoe in Oklahoma. Remember that game? And Oklahoma
great
beat
game.
Ohio State in the Horseshoe.
Franklin's back in as quarterback. So he watched as Matty Mauk tried to move the ball, did not. In fact, Tigers only have 52 yards here with 8:33 to go. They're 1 of 5 on third downs. They have been stymied by this Aggie defense from the end zone. Far side and grabbed by LaDainian Washington. His first catch of the night.
Well, prior to that completion, they had only completed 4 passes and the longest for 6 yards. They know they've got to be able to get downfield and beat this man-to-man coverage. That time they were able to do it.
23-yard gain. Let me tell you something about number two. You know this. If he gets a step on that Aggie secondary, lights out. He's the fastest of the receivers here. He is a legitimate 4-4 weapon. Now Franklin keeps it on the running play, breaks free, got another first down out to the 42-yard line. Matthews, the safety, forced to make the stop on James Franklin.
And nice job up front by this offensive line, opening that up for James Franklin. He can do that now. I mean, he's known for running the option. He has 73 carries coming into the year. He's a power-running quarterback with his size at about 230 pounds.
This Missouri offensive line, or at the start of this drive, and he has given the quarterback time to throw, opening up a running lane. Evan Bain, the trigger man at center. Franklin going to do it again. Runs out for about 8 yards behind this offensive line. I want you to take a look at that left guard, Jovan. That's a young man from Billings, Montana. Went to West High School over there. His daddy's a Missouri graduate. Now, the Grizz wanted to come on over to Missoula. He could have been a big, big player. He said, I want to go down and play at Missouri. He walked on.
I know. It's a great story.
Hard worker and became a starting left guard. And here he is. Josie breaks free. And they are really starting to move the ball on the ground.
Good job here to start this series. They opened it up with a nice pass play to Washington. Now they're running the ball. And remember, A&M has a fragile defensive mindset. They played well early in this game, but it's a long way to go still to try to stop James Franklin and the Tigers offense.
Franklin checks over to that sideline. Henry Joseph, one of the great stories here in Columbia, coming back after major knee surgery. He flares to the left, check down pass. Franklin going to keep it again and could not get back to the line of scrimmage. Gives up a couple of yards that time.
That time, A&M's defense in the right place. That was a true freshman, Deshane Hall, who dropped into coverage there. One thing that we can see on this drive is that experience. You know, we do games all over the country. You see a guy who's a senior back there, there's just a different kind of feel where the game is slowed down and he makes much better decisions, and it kind of a poised, calm demeanor that we see from James Franklin. Even though they're down seven, he still is able to distribute that kind of attitude to his team.
Green Beckham. And he is to about the 38-yard line. Honeycutt with the stop.
Green Beckham is usually more of a threat with the ball in the air, where they put it up and let him make a play. Not as dangerous with the ball in his hands after the catch, but this does set up another third down. As we both have talked about, they've struggled in this area tonight against A&M's defense, only 1 of 5.
Franklin, only 5 of 8 for 44 yards. And 3rd and 6, goes downfield for it all. Touchdown, Missouri! Doriel Green Beckham. Green Beckham's 10th touchdown catch of the year, 38 yards on 3rd and 6. Baggett on to attempt the tying extra point. Deadlocked at 7. So Franklin got one of the big fellas open and threw a beautiful strike. And Herbie, the topping on that 94-yard drive.
Yeah, the matchups up here at the top with Green Beckham against Everett. Remember, the first down marker is right here. And I think Everett really got surprised, because I think he's anticipating a shorter route. But you can see right here, the safety's occupied right here. It's one-on-one, and now it's just a foot race. The ball is thrown way in front, and we talked about where Green Beckham does his damage is when he catches the ball in the air, in the end zone, or goes up and over a defender. But I think that time, really, DeShazer Everett fooled on 3rd and 6 with the play call from Missouri.
94-yard scoring drive, tied at 7. The young man who pulled in the touchdown pass, Molina and Williams, back deep. And it'll come out to the 25-yard line. We go to Reese Davis for an update. Reese.
All right, Brett, Taco Bell studio update. Battle for the victory bell. It's on ABC, UCLA, and USC. Miles Jack goes in. You know the 7-0 deficit, the largest deficit Coach O has faced at USC as a head coach, but it's early going to the second quarter.
Miles Jack, what a story. Outstanding linebacker when we had it in Oregon. Suddenly he's become one of the better running backs, power backs in the Pac-12.
They've had some injuries on that side of the ball. Noel Mazzone, the offensive coordinator, said, hey, I've seen you in practice messing around with the football. Come on over here. Try to carry the football. And he's become quite a story the last 4 or 5 weeks.
Brandon Williams back on the field, number 5. He's there with Cameron Clear alongside Manziel. Williams breaks free. 45, midfield in a foot race. And brought down at the 31-yard. Matt White saves the touchdown.
I thought he brought an energy the last time he was in there. Watch the center this time, Matthews. What a great job of just kind of bouncing around and getting his hands up on Harold Brantley. That sealed it. That opened it up. There's the block right there by Matthews. And then the acceleration to get through by Brandon Williams.
And they come right back with a quick throw to Gonzalez. Gonzalez, the receiver, after that 43-yard run. Once they hit and get a big first down, they play a little up-tempo football right now.
Well, again, Brandon Williams, when he's had his hands on the ball, seems to ignite this offense.
Manziel. Sack. Back at the 35. Marcus Golden, number 33, was all over him. A young man from St. Louis.
Again, a great job by this Missouri defensive front. They've got to try to keep him contained. Don't let him get to the outside. Fight to the outside right there by Brantley. And eventually the rest of his friends come in to help him out.
Third down and 10. Mantell hit on a release, end zone, touchdown, Texas A&M, Darrell Walker. Beautiful throw under pressure by Manziel.
And that time, there actually was the seams. The ends got upfield, and it allowed Johnny Manziel to step up just enough to buy enough time to be able to put the ball into the air to Walker. And I'm not so sure that time Missouri's defensive backs maybe got caught looking into the backfield and watching Johnny Manziel. And I think that's why Walker got behind the coverage.
The extra point is good. Lambeau makes it 14-7, Texas A&M. So just like that, Johnny Football puts the Aggies back ahead here against Missouri. But tomorrow morning, get your NFL Sunday started off on the right foot. First at 10 a.m. Eastern on ESPN. Sunday NFL Countdown. Chris and the gang will have all the latest updates from around the league until kickoff. And then before you set your fantasy lineups, get fantasy football now, 11 a.m. on ESPN2. Our experts will give you all the latest info. That was an unbelievable scoring strike with Sam draped all over Manziel.
Yeah, Sam,
time.
Of course, 10 sacks on the year, 17 tackles for a loss. You know that he's eventually going to get there. And Johnny felt him, and he got the ball off just in time.
With 4:06 remaining here for the Tigers, Herbie, and Murphy back deep again.
Yeah, what a difference a week makes as far as the energy from Johnny Manziel.
Come out to the 25-yard line. Back to that score.
Yeah, we talked about the importance of not allowing Manziel to step up into the pocket. You can see the ends both get upfield, and there's the huge creases to be able to step up into the pocket. Sam is closing in. He gets the ball off just in time, but I think it was a broken coverage. Either that or Randy Ponder kind of gets caught looking into the backfield. You can kind of see he and the safety looking at each other, Matt White, but that was a breakdown clearly in coverage, and Manziel not only avoids the pressure, somehow is able to find Walker in that broken coverage by the Tigers defense.
Hansbrough in as the running back. Missouri will try to get even here before the intermission. Franklin, 6 of 9, 82 yards. 38 yards of that, of course, the touchdown pass. First down. Into high. Bring Beckham over there working the sideline with that great size. Nobody can get up there. Herbie, you pointed that out early.
And I thought the last drive was the first time we saw James Franklin really find a rhythm for this offense and get things going with the running and also the passing.
Hansborough barges ahead for the first down and keeps going. Terrific second effort run there by the young man from Arlington, Texas. You know, Bowie High School.
People think about Missouri and they think about Gary Pinkel and they think about, oh, they're from the Big 12. They spread you around. That finesse offense won't work in the SEC. Gary Pinkel prides himself, whether it's the Big 12 or the SEC. They run the football and they can be physical up front.
He hands it off. And the running back trying to get the edge. Picks up about 3 yards on that play before Tony Hurd gets him out of bounds. So here's your second down for the Tigers. Franklin keeps it and just to battle his way back to the line of scrimmage. Steven Jenkins, the linebacker, with a fine play.
Boy, that's what I think Mark Snyder's really been wanting to see from the senior. Jenkins this time, no hesitation at all. He reacted so quickly that it just did not give this offensive line, Justin Britt, the left tackle, a chance to get up to him. Great recognition and good acceleration to the play there by the senior.
Marcus Murphy, the running back. Third and six. A diving Washington catch.
A gutsy catch, isn't it, Brent?
Unbelievable
catch. You talked about his speed, but this is a heck of a play. You know that a safety's coming. I mean, you start to dive into the teeth of that defense. You know someone's coming in there. Great concentration on third down to keep this drive alive.
Young man from Shreveport, Louisiana. And Franklin back again. Offensive line gives him time. And Green Beckham didn't hold on that time. Looks like he had a shot right at the first down marker, but there was coverage over there. Was pretty good that time by Jacobs.
Yeah, Jacobs in for Everett there, and Everett's been going against Green Beckham quite a bit. And when Jacobs gets in there, he's got to be able to hold the line there, out there isolated, again, against that very tall, physical wide receiver.
Just inside of 2 minutes left for Mizzou. Second down and 10. Trailing Texas A&M by 7. South Carolina having a big night. They lead Clemson at home. And, of course, they're pulling for the Aggies to win here. Under pressure, throws it up downfield, incomplete. Had no chance on that. They were closing in, and he has to throw it away.
And watch how physical Devontae Harris is. This is a sophomore who played a lot as a freshman. Right there, he gets physical. This is what the crowd's reacting to, but he's doing his job. It's exactly how he's coached. That time, he just got the best of Washington.
Third down and 10. Option. Murphy. And he is short of the first down.
Interesting call. All three timeouts. Got to be thinking Gary Pinkel's thinking about trying to maybe go for it here. He got very, very close there. He's about fourth and three. Interesting call there with the option on third and long.
And Jenkins is hobbled and has to sit down here on the fourth and three, so he'll have to come out for at least a play. And while we have this opportunity, let's check in with Reese Davis. Reese.
Brent, Buick Halftime Report is coming up. Another week, another miracle for Auburn, and the Tigers are in the middle of the BCS National Championship discussion. Ohio State stayed there, but by the skin of its teeth against Michigan, and we'll also show you what's going on with South Carolina and Clemson. Gamecocks up by a touchdown right now and having a chance to put together a scoring drive. Mark and Lou are here. We'll see you in just a few minutes.
Nyreese, and here the Aggie defense has been the main story. As Johnny Manziel, of course, playing through a little pain here tonight, has the Aggies ahead 14-7. Had a couple of scoring passes, but the big thing is the fact, Irby, that this Aggie defense has been able to hold Mizzou to only 181 yards at one touchdown. They have led teams by double digits in all their SEC games.
Absolutely, especially at half by an average of 18 points. This is where you got to wonder about the size of the receivers and Franklin getting one-on-one matchups. Does he find one that he likes and tries to put it up high to let him make a play on it?
Fourth down and three, 1:25. They're going to run the quarterback for the first down to the 34-yard line.
Formation.
They'll reset the ball and start the clock again.
Use the formation with the empty formation. There aren't any linebackers home. They're spread all over the field. And James Franklin and that offensive line gets to push and picks up the first down.
Three receivers to the right. Snaps it off to Marcus Lucas. That's his first catch of the night. Hurd making the stop.
Gary Pinkel will use his first timeout.
So we'll go to break. 54 seconds remaining in the first half. Well, tradition's found a new home. The most storied conference in college athletics will live on a new network, the SEC Network, launching August 2014. And for more information, go to www.getsecnetwork.com. Now, that'd be great. DirecTV can bring you the SEC Network, and maybe they double back and give us the Pac-12 Network in Montana, too. Just a little needle
like that.
There.
You know, yeah, I would like that myself. So this is going to be interesting to see how this first half ends. Still two timeouts, 54 seconds to go. A veteran quarterback who's been here many, many times before knows how to manage the clock here late in the half.
Missouri's starting to move the football a little bit. Remember the last time they drove 94 yards. Now it's second down and four. Inside of a minute, strike incomplete. Washington had broken free. And he led him just a little bit too much, or it would have been six against Harris.
Remember, Harris got the best of him last time, and this time Washington gets around him. Harris actually said, hey, he's hitting me in the face mask. Say there towards the end of the play, but James Franklin had him. Washington did his job getting around the press coverage. He was open, and Franklin just overthrew him.
Hansbrough in as the protector, third down and four. You can see the three rangy receivers off to the left. They'll burn a timeout on the Texas A&M side here. This week on ESPN's Monday Night Football, two of the NFC's elite teams meet. Drew Brees, the New Orleans Saints, will go out west. Russell Wilson, the Seattle Seahawks. Folks, I cannot stress the importance of that game. Should they meet again for a conference championship, home field could be the difference.
Stress it.
A dome.
Stress it, baby.
Rain and snowstorm.
That's
in
a
the
big
great
one.
Northwest. So that's Monday night out in Seattle.
You got a good one there.
Don't miss. Here's Josie in now as the running back. 49 seconds remaining. Missouri trailing Texas A&M 14-7. Trapped, dancing around. It'll bring up a fourth down. Jenkins, that linebacker in there again. Remember, he was shaken up, left, and came back.
What great play, not only by Jenkins, but the defensive line that time from Texas A&M.
The ball is just inside the 30-yard line, around, you know, about a 47-yard field goal attempt with Andrew Baggett. That has not been the specialty of Missouri. The offense still out there on the field. They're bringing the time down before he kills the clock, though. He's got the head linesman over there alongside, and he says, I want you to stop it with X number of seconds remaining. So Missouri, a win away from playing for an SEC championship. But you know, Herbie, he made a real good point early in his broadcast. The pressure, and the longer they go behind in this game, yeah, there's going to be more and more pressure on the Tigers.
Yeah, and I think early in this game, it was almost like they were in a little bit of a fog. And, you know, they've made a few plays. They've gotten themselves back in. And it's going to be an interesting second half. And the story of the game, to me, has really been the way the two defenses have played.
Absolutely.
How about A&M's defense? Much maligned. They've had so much youth this year on that side of the ball. They've stepped up big. And also, you got to give Missouri, Dave Steckel's group, they've done a great job of containing Johnny Manziel, not giving up too many big plays.
And Manziel, of course, is trying to shake off a couple of injuries. He was wrapped pretty good on that one passing attempt, and he came in with an injured right thumb.
He sure has. He's had to kind of battle through it, and I think a lot of people are anticipating this more than likely being his last regular season game, and he wants to go out a winner, especially after the way he and his team played a week ago against LSU. He's here to compete.
And for the Aggies, of course, a win here tonight, and that would probably move them up the bowl chain in the SEC. 47-yard field goal attempt. Texas A&M wants a timeout. And remember, they had a youngster on special teams do some great work. And, of course, you know, when I think about field goals, I immediately think about today's Alabama-Auburn game. I mean, with Alabama... Is that the fourth field goal, the one that was returned 100 yards for the winning touchdown?
I think it was.
Ago?
Yeah, they missed three earlier.
They changed field goal kickers.
They get a second. They get the second added onto the clock. They bring in the long-distance kicker. And everyone's thinking, oh, geez, don't get it blocked. What if it gets blocked and Auburn maybe returns it and forget the getting blocked? Oh, no. My man's going to go 108. That was...
So the SEC East... Now, will the winner, and again, if Missouri wins, it's pretty easy. They go down, and they will play Auburn next Saturday in Atlanta. But if Missouri loses here tonight, South Carolina wins the tiebreaker because they overcame a 17-point deficit right here to beat Missouri. And so here's your fourth down now, your field goal attempt, Andrew Baggett. Webb is the holder. Veering off to the right. No good. As the first half comes to an end, the Aggies have held Missouri to 7 points here in the first half.
It's a team that had an average margin of the lead at the half of 18 points in SEC play.
Let's go down now to Heather Cox.
Brent, thanks so much. Coach, what would you like to see your defense to really get to Johnny Manziel and rattle him a little bit more?
Well, you know, he's a really good player. Holding them to 14 points and a half is not bad. I mean, offensively is where we're struggling. I mean, we got to do more. We have more opportunities. They're playing better defense. We're playing offense right now. So I think that's really what our focus is going to be.
And, Coach, you're a win away from playing in the SEC championship game. How do you help your players turn that pressure into a positive and sort of loosen up a bit?
Well, I think we just got to go in there and settle down a little bit and do everything we can to help them come out so they can play a better second half.
Coach, thank you. Brent?
Thank you, Heather. Coach Pinkel and the Tigers down by 7 here. Texas A&M with the lead. That's the lone Mizzou touchdown. Doriel Green Beckham. Meanwhile, Johnny Manziel able to light it up, finding Walker for the go-ahead score. Welcome back to ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by Hampton Hotels and the SEC on ESPN. Texas A&M leading Missouri 14-7 at the half here in Columbia, Missouri, and it's time for our Discover Game Changer, brought to you by Discover Card. And this was Johnny Football taking a beating early.
He sure was. Missouri did a really good job of containing him, getting pressure. You can see at one point he comes over to the sideline, but he did respond. 12 of 16. He finds Walker for a touchdown near the end of the first half to give the Aggies a 14-7 lead. It'll be an interesting second half for him and for this Aggies offense.
Well, thinking about the second half, you would expect Missouri to loosen up a little bit here on offense. We really have not seen their A game here tonight.
That's a good point, and I think some of it is maybe some of their own doing, and a lot of it has to do with what Mark Snyder and the Aggies defense has been able to do, just being very, very multiple. And I think this A&M defense, you got to remember, they're very young. They've been beaten up in the SEC, but they've also grown as the year has gone on, and we'll see if they hold up here. They don't have a ton of depth. We'll see if they hold up here in the second half.
Missouri will handle the ball first here in the second half. And away we go. It'll come out on the 25-yard line, and let's check it down below with the third member of our crew, Heather Cox. Heather.
Brett, in that first half, as you mentioned, Johnny Manziel did get that left ankle dinged up. He went into the locker room with that left ankle taped. He came out of the locker room with both ankles taped to try to disguise that injury. Kevin Sumlin said he will just battle through it. Sumlin also very impressed with the way his defense played. They came in under a lot of pressure into this game. He said they've been stout. They've run to the ball, tackled in space, gave up only one big play. He said the key in the second half is going to be special teams and forcing a turnover.
Now, Kevin has been very good when leading at the intermission. And in case you did not see that breaking story, earlier today it was announced that he had agreed to a six-year extension of his contract in College Station with Texas A&M. Josie, the running back, on first down, and it's a strong first down, a powerful run for 10 yards by the junior from Angleton, Texas.
Well, that's the way you set the tone, an offensive line getting off the ball and relying on your back to give that second and third effort to pick up those tough yards. You pick up a first down, and again, any quarterback loves to see that to start a new series and a new half.
He has a two-year-old boy at home, and I asked him if he recognizes him. He said, oh, yeah. Daddy's got the football.
He'll
back.
Be happy after that.
First down and 10. Here he comes again. Saddle up the middle of that offensive line. Copeland, Bame, and McGovern. And make the Aggies stop them here early.
Yeah, they're physical up front. Mark Snyder moving this defense. The defensive line kind of slanting from one way to another. That time they slanted the right way. And Darian Claiborne, the middle linebacker, 48, he has been all over the field. Right now he's lined up to the outside. They're really using him a lot.
Four receivers spread the field. Duncan couldn't find one open, so he takes off. Good runner. Got another first down for Mizzou before he is wrestled out of bounds.
Well, when you rush three, it makes it easy for the quarterback. If you've got everybody covered, somebody's got to make a play right there. You rush three and you drop eight, you've got all your eyes on the quarterback. Somebody, when he starts to take off to run, has got to make a play in space. That time, they did not protect the edge of the defense.
Missouri's moved out to the 49-yard line. They come back with Josie.
Gary Pinkle telling Heather Cox, we're just not playing good enough offense right now. They're playing better than us on their defense. He clearly got that message across to the offensive line. They're starting to assert themselves a little bit up front.
That option look again. Franklin fakes the pitch, keeps it. First down, breaks across that 40-yard line. Terrific opening drive here. Herbius Askew makes the stop.
Seeing a little bit of everything right now. We saw Josie make a big run, break some tackles here. You'd love to see a quarterback shake off an arm tackle from Steven Jenkins. And it's the little things like that that keep drives alive. The line coming off the ball, the quarterback breaking tackles, getting outside, breaking contain.
So they'll snap it at the 37-yard line here on this opening drive. Franklin going deep in zone. Caught to the 1-yard line. LaDainian Washington, the speedster. It's first and goal, Tigers.
We keep talking about the corners needing to hold up one-on-one. Man coverage. There's not a safety in the middle of the field. It's speed against speed. Mano a mano. Who's going to make a play? And again, Washington that time gets the best of Harris and gets by him.
Murphy stays on as the running back after that 35-yard strike to Washington. First down and goal. Clock is down to 5 seconds. Murphy, touchdown Mizzou. First drive of the second half. They march 75 yards and they're an extra point away from tying the Aggies.
Outstanding execution by Missouri to open up the second half. A balanced attack to move the ball in 7 plays and 75 yards right down the field.
ties it. LaDainian Washington, the 6'4", 205-pound receiver from Shreveport, Louisiana. Set it up. Murphy charges across the goal line.
Visit WatchESPN.com or download the WatchESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Now, quickly, fortunes can change on this Saturday as we come down the stretch in college football. Missouri has tied Texas A&M, and Clemson has drawn even with South Carolina in a non-conference game. Remember, for South Carolina to play Auburn next Saturday, Missouri would have to lose this game. If the Tigers come on now and win it, they will go to Atlanta next Saturday afternoon. Molina back deep with Trey Williams. At the goal line is Williams. Sidestep 15. And he will be tackled right about the 20-yard line. And that's where Johnny Manziel will come. Let's go back to that score.
Yeah, nice job on the right side of the offensive line. Morrison McGovern right here just sealing it. But what I love is to see the wide receivers help out and do their job. Green Beckham and Jimmy Hunt, watch them help seal this. The line does a great job. But those receivers who get all the attention for their size and catching the football, they also show that they can do a job blocking and open up some running lanes for these backs.
Trey Carson will open the second half as the running back alongside Manziel. Here comes Carson. Good first down run. Brothers with another stop. But when you think about Manziel and how he was stopped last week against LSU, held to 39%. He's completing 75% here tonight. He was picked off twice down Baton Rouge and hasn't been intercepted here tonight. Carson stopped, and it's going to be third down and 6 coming up. Hope makes another stop, the defensive lineman.
This defense probably reacting and feeding off of some of the energy that their offense started this half with. It's a big third down, not just in this ball game, but overall, I think, for the momentum of the football game here early to start this second half.
Manziel back, straight back. Now he takes off. Can he get the first down? It is close here on the near side. Wilson, the linebacker, in pursuit.
They got pressure on him in a hurry. He had to bail. Rare blitz from Missouri. He recognizes that, sees Brothers, the outside linebacker, come and gives a heck of an effort to try to get to the first down marker.
The crowd didn't think it was a first down, but the official marking it gave it to him. So it's first down and 10, and the chains will move. Ankle wrap. Sore right thumb after bouncing it off the helmet of his center, Mike Matthews, a few games ago. And some NFL fellows who play quarterback who know about that injury. They've hit some helmets through the years. That can really affect the passing game. And
delay a game.
Yeah.
Delay of game. Offense, number 2. 5 yard penalty. Remains first down.
That's only the second penalty against Texas A&M. There have been 3 penalties against Missouri in this game.
See some miscommunication and frustration on A&M's part with the play clock. Mike Evans, a very quiet night again tonight for A&M's offense.
And first down and 15. They'll come with Carson and not much doing. This will be second down and long. Michael Sam, number 52, with a stop. What a season he has had. Michael Sam, 10 sacks. He was not recruited by Texas A&M, even though he grew up very close to that campus. Hitchcock, Texas, went to Hitchcock High School, wanted to go to Texas A&M, wasn't offered, so here he is at Missouri, and they are delighted to have him. Second down and 14. Long time in the pocket. Long time. Receivers covered, so he drops it off to Carson. Well short of that first down. Gaines comes up.
You know, and Sam is known for a guy who rushes the quarterback, but I think he does a really good job of being a complete player in this conference. We saw the previous play, him shedding a block and making a play against the run as well. But this is his specialty. This is where he and the rest of the defensive line, of course, he'll check out there. But the rest of this defensive line, they get after the quarterback on third down.
So third down and 10, they try to box Manziel in. In's hold, they throw him back. He shakes the first tackle. Moving hard to the left. Fires, diving attempt incomplete. Terrific job by those defensive ends of boxing him in.
Yeah, that's what we talked about in the open, how important it is to not necessarily get upfield, just kind of keep him inside there, rely on the coverage to make a play, and then eventually the pressure from the defensive line can get in there. It's a combination of coverage downfield and boxing him in, as you said, kind of corralling him in that pocket.
Drew Kayser will punt it away. Marcus Murphy is back deep. Murphy driven back. Beautiful punt. Back pedals to the 12. Now escapes the first tackler. Still going. 20-yard line. 25 and out to the 35. A brilliant return by number 6, Marcus Murphy from DeSoto, Texas. 32-yard return, and the Tigers could be in business. Once you shake that first tackler on a punt return, you can pick up some yardage, and that's what Murphy does here.
ESPN College Football Primetime, brought to you by Dr. Pepper 10, the manliest low-calorie soda in the history of mankind, and Taco Bell. Sometimes you gotta live mas.
Well, earlier tonight, the fourth-ranked Missouri volleyball team was honored with a win over Arkansas Wednesday. The Tigers became the first ever SEC volleyball team to post an undefeated regular season. They get ready for the NCAA tournament. They'll find their seed tomorrow. The Final Four, of course, is out in Seattle starting December 19th. And here are the Mizzou Tigers with Franklin at quarterback. Hansbrough comes back on the field. He'll be the running back. Coming off a 75-yard touchdown drive the last time, Hansbrough breaks the daylight. 10 yards on first down, and they're starting to punish the Aggie defense.
Boy, he does a good job of pressing this and then finding the opening to the backside. Just a great feel and a great job here by Hansbrough, the sophomore. Felt it plate side and cut it to the backside.
And they move quickly here on second and one, then they check over the sideline. Britt Copeland, Bame, McGovern, Morse, that front line starting to pave the way here for these running backs. That little quick screen to the outside, and there's Green Beckham, who scored Tigers' first touchdown, picking up the first down. Jenkins with the stop.
Hit him the football out in space with his size. He can make a catch, and that short a distance can easily pick up that first down. Remember what Missouri did the last time they had the football. They were in rhythm. They were balanced, spreading it, taking a few shots downfield, and running the football.
They're at the Texas A&M 44-yard line. Right back with Hansbrough to the 39-yard line.
Really the first time all night that we've seen Missouri on this series to start and their first series to start the second half where they were the aggressor. They are taking control of things up front with the line of scrimmage and the offensive line. It's opening up their running game and making it a lot easier on James Franklin in this passing game.
285 total yards over the middle. And this will be another first down, and that's Washington again.
These linebackers kind of freeze. They're looking and respecting the backside of the backfield. It opens up that big vacancy in the hole in the backside behind the linebackers and in front of the safeties. You run the football, it can play with the eyes of those linebackers and make them respect the line of scrimmage and those running backs.
Now Josie in as a running back, out as a receiver. End zone! No, he had Lucas open, and they could not connect. Second down and 10. Franklin had a sure 6 points that time. Marcus was wide open.
He just shook Howard Matthews and went right around him. And it was actually who James Franklin was looking at the entire way. It didn't surprise him. That's the read that he made. He did a good job of being able to get his feet set. He just missed on the throw. It's the second time we've seen him miss an open receiver behind coverage where he's missed long.
One of the things you see, in fact, there's a couple of things I noticed with the Missouri offense. Number one, they keep a running back there much more than they did in the Big 12 days. They went empty all the time. Tonight, I can't remember them going empty. Quick to the outside. They still stretch the field with those outside receptions. But the other thing I noticed, the line splits are not as big as they used to be here back in the days of the Big 12. Remember those Mike Leach line splits over there in Lubbock?
Yeah.
Well, you take a look at this Mizzou offensive line, and they're a lot tighter now. And that's probably because of the power they face in the SEC with the defensive linemen. And they're keeping that running back there, as you see Josie, just in case someone breaks free on James Franklin, just to give him a little bit more protection. But they've made some changes. Here comes Franklin on the run. First down and goal at the 5-yard line.
Again, the line continues to get a great push up front. This time it's Bam, 77. Watch the push right there at the point of attack. Clears out Hendrick Walker and opens it up again. That time on third and short, the big center taking control up front.
Missouri looking for its first lead. Throw, end zone, jump ball, pulled down. Washington incomplete, juggling as he went out of bounds. A side judge right there. Everett had coverage. Washington thinks he had six. Take a look at the replay.
He said, throw the flag. Throw the red flag out. We don't have that in college, but he wants to let his coach know he made the catch here. Well, it sure looks like it.
Boy, is that
you
close.
Can see why he
goes all the way down to the ground in the end zone, doesn't he?
See if he completes the process of the catch. He sure does. Didn't look like he bobbled it. You could see why he was so adamant. They're going to take another look at it.
There's no question they're going to take a look at that upstairs.
Only on the field was an incomplete pass. The previous play is under further review.
Steve Landis is just down the hall from us down here. He's the replay official here for this SEC crew. Kenny Williamson is your referee. Wally Huff is your umpire. Take another look at this.
What a tremendous effort going up to make the catch. Everett actually gets his hand on the football, but Washington showing strength with his hands. I don't think he ever lost control of the ball, and he got a foot down. And that's what they'll look at if he completed the process of the catch and make a determination of whether or not he bobbled it after he hit the ground. But as far as what we're looking at, it looks like he's able to secure it.
Well, for sure, Herbie, the one thing that's going on is that this offense is showing a heartbeat here in the second half.
Yeah,
this is a different offense right now.
I think Gary Pinkel and his offensive staff really challenged the offensive line. The biggest difference is the offensive line. Plays, they've gained at least 5 yards.
Marlena Williams back deep. Williams again. Short of the 20-yard line by about 6 yards. Good coverage. Herbie, take a look at tonight's good hands play brought to you by Allstate. No doubt about it.
Well, this is a great one to select. Damian Washington just made this play, and tremendous effort and concentration to be able to go up and kind of high point the ball. He's up isolated against the Shazer Everett, who's been benched and not playing, but he came back for this series, and he has to deal with this play. He actually made a decent play on the ball to swat at it right there, but the hand strength of Washington secures it, gets the foot down, touchdown for the Tigers.
Now it's the reigning Heisman Trophy winner, Johnny Manziel. Molina, his running back. Big hole on the left side, barges for 9 yards on first down.
Yeah, you go back to the beginning of this game. What was A&M's trying to establish? The run game. They felt that the last couple weeks they had abandoned that running game too early. They wanted to be able to run against this defensive front to try to set up Manziel in the quick throw.
There is that quick strike to the outside. Great defense that time by number 7, Randy Ponder from Edmond, Oklahoma.
And remember, Randy Ponder had a little mix-up with Matt White on one of Manziel's touchdown passes. That time, he didn't hesitate at all. Ponder, quick reaction, and a great job there to make that play.
Third down and one. Manziel ever so dangerous on these third and short. Quick pitch, and that's the first down to Gonzalez. LaQuiviante Gonzalez from Cedar Hill, Texas, went to Cedar Hill High School. Great upside here with this young man.
And they brought a linebacker on a blitz with Brothers, and it left White too far of a cushion against the receiver. Great recognition by Manziel and the quickness to get the ball out of his hands accurately.
One of the quickest releases, Herbie, we've seen in a long time.
No doubt.
College football. High snap, tries to get it. Molina does, but it was a little bit botched at the beginning of that play. Did not develop quickly enough, and Ely able to eat it up on that side. There's another good defensive end.
And they had to tight end the senior Nehemiah Hicks in the backfield with him, something they've not shown much of tonight, in fact, at all. There he is running off the field. You put a big fella like that, 255 pounds in the backfield, chances are the smaller back's going to try to follow him around the corner. Missouri able to be aware of that and sniffed it out real quick.
Aggies need 12 yards on this second down. Manziel going to try to hoof it. Short of the first down. Look at that rascal trying to steal the extra yard.
You can never question his competitive spirit. He'll leave it all out there. And, you know, I think A&M knew coming in, Brent, it was going to be a challenge against this Missouri defensive line. This team leads the SEC in sacks. You knew they'd get after Johnny Manziel, and he's got to create, and this could be another chance for him to try to do that on third down.
Mike Matthews snaps it to him. Manziel going to drop it down now to Molina, and Molina might have been short of that. He's short. The line judge has got it marked. E.J. Gaines and Kentrell Brothers up there to seal it off, and no first down.
This is why you signed the big contracts as a head coach, right? To make this call. This is why you signed the big one right here, boys. He's going to go for it in a game that's been a little lopsided here in the second half with the ball in his own territory.
Rolling the dice. Why not get a six-year contract extension to Texas A&M? Playing with house money tonight. Go for it, Kevin. Mantell looking for a receiver. Can't find one. In trouble a little bit now. Dances underneath. Got the first down with Trey Williams. Checked it down all the way, and his running back camped out by the sideline.
And Brent, he wanted to go right here to Labhart. Right there, he decided to pull out of it. Once he pulled out of it, now it's just backyard football. Somebody's got to try to make a play. He comes off of Labhart and scrambler finds the running back out of the backfield.
Looking to throw back, incomplete, second down. One thing, Herbie, that we need to talk about a little bit, that's the job that E.J. Gaines is doing overall on Mike Evans. E.J. has been assigned to 13. No matter where he goes, the Mizzou coaches decided on that, along with Gary Pinkel. And I'm going to tell you, that young man right there, a veteran from Independence, Missouri, and he has done a heck of a job tonight.
Quiet night for Mike Evans. You see Johnny Manziel getting after the freshman, Gonzalez, there.
Now he fires to Evans, gains in on top of him immediately.
Yeah, Missouri will take that all night. I mean, this is a matchup. You know, really coming into this game, Mike Evans has not been able to put up big numbers in the last 3 or 4 weeks. He's been relatively quiet, and it continues tonight with Gaines being able to play him out there by himself. Remember, Gaines, an all-conference type of corner.
Evans has caught 3 passes, but for only 14 yards. And now it is 3rd down and 7. That's how well E.J. Gaines is doing. Taboyo has checked in as one of the 5 receivers out there. The Aggies going to go with 5. Mizzou rushing 3 now. Manziel looking for somebody open. Now he's going to take off. Trying to get the first down. And Wilson was rustling him to the ground. The line judge will come down there and spot it.
He's trying to use the umpire. He's trying to use anybody he can. It's like playing basketball. You use a pick, you know. The umpire is kind of a moving target there.
He's one of my favorite gamers to watch, I got to tell you. Going again on 4th down. And why not? Well, you got Manziel back there. Go for it. Power run. And the whistle blew. Whistle blew before Carson.
A flag down.
Would come.
Prior to the snap, false start, offense, number 70. 5-yard penalty, remains 4th down.
Oboihe, Cedric Oboihe, the right tackle.
Brent, the defensive line moved just prior to the ball being snapped. Abuhi jumped, and instead of going for it, maybe picking it up, watch the defense move. They stemmed, and as they stemmed, he jumped, and now instead of going for it, they have to punt.
So on fourth and six, Murphy back deep now for Mizzou. Bobbles it. He regained control. About the 12-yard line. Well, tomorrow morning, get your NFL Sunday started off on the right foot. 10 a.m. Eastern, Chris and the gang. They'll have the latest news from around the league. And then before you set your fantasy lineup, catch Fantasy Football Now, 11 a.m. on ESPN2. Well, Missouri has been lethal here in the second half.
Two drives and two touchdowns for James Franklin.
Josie will start off as the running back. On first down, Josie behind the right side keeps going with that second effort. I'll tell you something about Josie and Coach Gary Pinkel. It was so stirring when he came back and played that first football game after that major, major knee operation. He gave the game ball to Josie. Now Coach Pinkel does not give game balls to individuals. He picks out units. But he felt so strongly about Henry Josie sticking with it that in an emotional post-game ceremony, Coach Pinkel gave him the game ball. That's how much he thinks of Josie. Second down and eight now. Franklin snaps it off. Wide open, Green Beckham breaks a tackle, still going. Horrible tackling by the Aggies that time.
And how about the recognition by Franklin on second down and long? He's got one of his favorite targets to the far right, to the bottom. Big cushion by Everett. Surprising that he would give him that big a cushion, but he does. And then you could see the effort there by Green Beckham. He's tough to bring down with his size.
That 26 yards boosts Franklin over 200 yards for the night. He's 15 of 22 now for 201 yards and two scoring strikes. Here comes Josie again. About the 36-yard line, there's going to be a big ovation from the sellout crowd at the Zoo. We come to the end of the third quarter. Missouri, 15 minutes away from playing for an SEC championship against Auburn. You all saw that coming, didn't you? Missouri and Auburn for the SEC? Oh, yeah. That's the difference right there. Back with the money quarter in just a moment. Welcome back to ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by Hampton Hotels and the SEC on ESPN. Well, folks, Allstate is celebrating its ninth year, sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets. Allstate makes contributions to participating University General Scholarship Funds for each field goal, extra point kick since 2005 now. Allstate has contributed more than $3.3 million in scholarship funds. Second down and six to start the fourth quarter from the Tigers 45-yard line. They took the lead in the third quarter when they moved for touchdowns on their two possessions. Is Franklin going to try to run for it? And no chance against Steven Jenkins.
Jenkins again quick to react. We've seen him make some plays. He also battling through some injuries. Can't help but just say that just watching James Franklin out there, just his body language, the way he leads this offense, even when they were down, he's always keeping his composure. And even now, here's a third down. It's easy to see why this team reacts to his leadership with the poise and the way he plays the game.
Big third down here for Missouri. Like to keep this going without giving Manziel the football back right away. But they're going to have to. The defense collapses on Franklin that time. Askew again making a play.
Yeah, they brought pressure to the outside, and I think he was able to come through there and get through the tight end that time, Eric Waters.
And that time, you know, we've seen a lot of rushing three and dropping eight from A&M on third down. I think they're sensing some urgency here. And now in the fourth quarter, that time Mark Snyder deciding to get much more aggressive on that third down call.
Harris back to receive this Brinzer punt. He is standing. What about the 23? Signals for the fair catch, then lets it go on the inside. Going to be tough field position. Going to be killed inside the 5-yard line. Johnny Manziel faces an uphill battle on this long field when you come back to Columbia.
A touchdown pass, extra point pending.
And Reese, if the USC coaching job opens up after this game, and Ed Orgeron is not retained, Kevin Sumlin is not available. 6-year extension with Texas A&M. From out of the end zone, Manziel flips it to the outside, and what? Gonzalez is lit up on that side. No chance. Number 17, Herbie, was all over him that time. White.
And Matt White came all the way from his safety spot to come all the way up. That's what surprised Manziel. He's expecting a corner to be out there. The corner sank, and White came all the way up from his safety spot to make the play.
Williams, the running back. Manziel fires in underneath now to Labhart. And Labhart picks up a big first down. What a good night he's had.
Yeah, the great thing that he does is he understands coverage. You know, he does a good job in zone coverage of finding the hole. And he and Johnny Manziel, these last five or six games, just seem to be in sync.
Play action, in trouble, steps away from the rush and batted incomplete. Andrew Wilson able to bat that pass down, and it will be second down and 10 for the Aggies.
Marcus Golden, the defensive end, thought he had a shot to get to Johnny Manziel, and he got a valuable lesson about never going up in the air and going with a ball fake. He gave him a little bit of a pump. Golden went airborne. He just stepped around him, and if it wasn't for the play of Wilson, that's another big completion for A&M.
Golden, a big pickup, went the JC route. Play action, Manziel in trouble again. In a foot race, has to drop it off. Complete. Wide open was Labhart. They're not accounting for Travis Labhart.
Well, there's the two backs in the backfield again. Hicks is back there along with Molina. He's going to come over from the right all the way to the left. The linebackers looked and saw those two backs. Their eyes kind of froze. They got caught up looking in the backfield. Nobody, as you say, Brent, accounted for the guy who's right now making the most plays for this offense, and that's Travis Labhart.
Six catches for 72 yards here tonight. Leading receiver for Manziel and the Aggies. First down and 10. Trey Williams, a running back, breaks the daylight. 45 to the 40-yard line.
This is a great call. They have a little bit of success with what they needed to do as far as throwing the football. It makes it a lot easier for the line to climb up and get to the second level. Outstanding quickness, and what a cut there by Williams to get back to the backside of that.
Aggies moving it. Quick pitch to the outside, and Walker, who scored a touchdown on a pass from Manziel in the first half. Ponder got Walker out of bounds.
Brett, doesn't this look like the first half A&M offense that we saw? I mean, we've not seen this the entire second half, but they're doing a heck of a job here. This drive started way back at their own 2-yard line, and they're doing a heck of a job here of quick throws and mixing up the play calling.
McClure, now the lead blocker, and Trey Williams. Starting to move the ball on the ground. They've used Molina, Williams, Brandon Williams, along with Trey and Trey Carson. So they've used four different running backs here tonight behind Manziel.
They got a stable of backs. They all bring something a little bit different to the table. That's Trey Williams' chance right now.
Third down and one. First down, 20, 15. Across the 10-yard line, it is first and goal for Texas A&M.
Boy, what a great job of blocking by Jake Matthews on the end, and also Cameron Clear right there. He chops down Sam, the defensive end, outside linebacker, but it's seal block, opened it up by Jake Matthews and got him around to the corner with Cameron Clear opening up the rest of the way.
Trying to finish off a 98-yard drive. Molina checks in. There it is, 98 yards.
with a touchdown. Ben Molina from Cedar Hill, Texas.
Touchdown.
Takes it in. They're an extra point away from a tie.
But this time he goes underneath the block from clear. See, clear in the backfield instead of going around it. This time he cuts underneath it and follows also another big black block by Mike Matthews. Boy, how about the A&M offensive line on that drive?
Did an outstanding job. The Matthews brothers, Harrison, if any, and oh boy, he. Josh Lamb. Tacks on the tying extra point.
Nine plays, 98 yards to tie this game up.
South Carolina leading Clemson and pulling for the Aggies. Missouri at home trying to earn the right to play Auburn for the SEC championship.
ESPN College Football Primetime is presented by Hampton Hotels. Feel the Hamptonality. And in part by Cadillac.
Well, the Allstate bus is here. And Herbie, the Allstate Ultimate Road Trip sweepstakes rolls on. Fans can go to college football, allstatecollegefootball.com. Chance at a trip to the Allstate Sugar Bowl. And you'll be hanging out with the winner.
Yeah, sure will. Takes about 60 seconds to fill out the form. Give it a shot. Just going to draw a name. See if you're the winner.
21 all. The SEC East title on the line and a berth in the championship game in Atlanta. 10:43 left in regulation. Murphy, the return man, runs up to the 10-yard line. Slips through close to the 30-yard line, and let us slip to Reese Davis. Reese.
Brent, SportsCenter right now, presented by Ally Bank. And the reason Missouri's trying to get to the SEC title game to play Auburn is because of this miraculous run from Chris Davis, taking a 57-yard missed field goal on the final play of the game and going end-to-end, officially 100 yards. He really ran 108 or so, and Auburn wins it 34-28 on the way to the SEC title game.
Yeah, Reese, in the NFL, it would be a 108-yard return. But in college football, when you come out like that, it's just basic a 100-yard return, giving credit for it. And Franklin abused Herbie on that play.
Well, good pressure here. Missouri's trying to catch A&M off guard. First and 10, and there's that slanting again. They bring a little bit of extra pressure. I'll tell you, Steven Jenkins is playing an outstanding football game tonight. He gets in on the blitz this time, gets around Justin Britt with a spin move, uses his quickness, and a gutsy call there by Mark Snyder with a first and 10 blitz.
So it is second and a bunch. Franklin checks over at the sideline. He got these talented wide receivers. He'd love to find one with some daylight. And that was not much downfield. That was Darius White. And Everett had coverage on that play. And that'll bring up third down and long.
Interesting to see A&M, a team that in this second half has had some soft coverage. They've been picked on in the back end. All of a sudden, when the game's on the line, every series matters. Starting to tighten things up a bit on these tall wide receivers from Missouri.
Need 15 yards. Franklin can't find an open receiver. Now he's in trouble. Has to throw it away. That was the freshman Hall from Lancaster, Texas, pressuring the quarterback.
Yeah, and it started with tight coverage. He wasn't even looking out to the field, and that's a long way. This is where he was looking. Tried a little bit of a rub route off the line of scrimmage, but just nobody open. He's got nowhere to go with the football, and eventually the pressure gets to him again. But gutsy, aggressive defensive scheme there on those three plays by A&M.
So Harris can give the Aggies and Manziel good field position. Standing on his own 35 for this punt. Fair catch at the 29-yard line.
Well, for a game that it's just gone back and forth, Missouri looking like they're just having their way, scoring two straight series to start the second half. And A&M's defense, the last two times, getting the ball back to Manziel. The first time, he gets a touchdown, and now we'll see what he does on this series.
Must-watch NFL Monday night. Saints Seahawks, Seattle, 8:25. Can Drew Brees take the Saints into Seattle and beat Russell Wilson? What do you think, Kirby?
It's tough to beat Pete Carroll on the road, but if anybody can do it, it's Drew Brees and Sean Payton.
No question.
Two of the better teams. You're so right about whichever team between those two gets home field.
Huge.
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 Who's at the top? Those two at the top right now in the NFC?
I think Seattle is still. George Hill, are they? Yeah. No, it's at.
George Hill's all over there. That's his hometown. Yeah, that's his ball club.
I'm going to volunteer him for that Final Four volleyball tournament to keep some stats out there.
He would appreciate that. Okay. Sure.
First down and 10 now. Brandon Williams. Now, Brandon Williams has had a good night. Carried five times for 60 yards here for the Aggie offense. So the transfer from Oklahoma is in. Manziel going to keep it. Forced back to the middle. And goes down. Good defense that time. Lucas Vincent, I think, was probably the first one to come in there, number 96.
Yeah, and they're going with the tight end back there. We saw Cameron Clear and also Nehemiah Hicks back there with the back. It's time they have just Williams back there by himself. You mentioned the yardage he put out. I thought he brought an energy to this offense as well.
Neither offense has turned the ball over tonight. Botch punt and a turnover, and Manziel in a foot race. Got to throw this baby away because that youngster Marcus Golden was closing in again. What a night he's had.
He should be proud of his effort. He's heard all week about corralling Johnny Manziel, and he tries to, but Manziel just takes off. Now it's a foot race, and instead of giving up, he continues to pursue him. That's a big man chasing down Johnny Manziel at 265 pounds. Forces him to just throw it away.
Manziel's thrown for 192 yards, 22 of 30. Faces 12 big yards here for a first down. They have to reach the 40-yard line to move the chains. Fires for it, incomplete. Aggies forced to punt.
Missouri just bringing four, gets to him. Got pressure off the edge, but this time it was actually pressure in the middle that affected Johnny Manziel and the accuracy. Good effort there by Harold Brantley and the rest of that defensive line to get into the vision and affect the throw there of Manziel.
We are coming to crunch time, folks. Tie game, 8-16. Will somebody win it or will somebody lose it? Fair catch, Murphy, at the 24-yard line. It's now up to the veteran, James Franklin, and the Mizzou offense. Can Franklin move it again? They've punted the last two times they've had the ball. What a day this would have been for the new SportsCenter app. Duke wrapping up the ACC Coastal. Michigan going for a win and losing by a point to Ohio State at the Big House. And then the big one, Alabama losing to Auburn. You can download it by calling SC from your phone. Well, here is James Franklin, and his father, Willie, is here tonight. Now, there is his father when he was in JC in Arizona. Went to Oklahoma, became a receiver. Second longest javelin throw in Oklahoma Sooner history. And he was an outstanding athlete, played in the National Football League for a while.
Now we know where James got that arm.
You got that right, huh? And here is James. He's got a little pops athletic ability, and his mom, Pamela's here tonight. Both of them, of course, watching.
I think you're going to see Missouri try to go back. Remember the first two times they had the football? They got physical at the line of scrimmage and ran the football to set up some throws downfield. I think you go back to that after these last two possessions have been slowed because of the pass rush from Texas A&M.
Josie is the running back alongside Franklin. Franklin missed four games this year with that separated shoulder. Got a little option look. Then the pitch to Josie, and it was well read by the Aggies. Not fooled. Honey cut the safety.
Well, I'm saying run the football. The only problem is, look at how many white jerseys are at the line of scrimmage. They've got nine guys up close tight to the line of scrimmage, and this time it's Clay Honeycutt, the safety, in space, making a play on Josie. Josie had nowhere to go with the ball. They had a man that accounted for the quarterback and a man for the pitch man. There's nowhere to go that time for Josie.
Now it comes to Franklin's arm. Third down and nine. Clock ticking. Deadlocked at 21. Pocket holds, fires for the first down, but he and the wide receiver, and there's the penalty flag. That'll be a first down. Tony Hurd, either holding or interference on that far side. He's saying that pass was not catchable.
Well, he held him for sure. Just grabbed the arm of Jimmy
Hunt. Interference, defense number four. The penalty will place the ball at the spot of the foul and includes an automatic first down.
Unfortunately for Tony Hurd, if he doesn't do this, and I don't think he ever saw the football. He's right here in coverage, sitting in the slot there, zone coverage. Never has his head turned. He grabs him once, grabs him twice. He never even saw the football thrown in the air. If he doesn't grab him, the ball's incomplete.
Remember now, that was a big third down. Fresh set of downs here for the Tigers at the 6:45 mark. Franklin scrambles out of it, now throws, and there's a penalty flag again thrown on the play.
It's got to be a hold, you would think, there by Missouri.
Holding, offense number 61. The penalty is 10 yards from the previous spot. Repeat first down.
It's Billings, Montana there on the hold.
Young Max Copeland.
That's your character here, 61, just off to the left here. Grabs a hold of that jersey, pulls the pants down, whatever it takes in Montana.
That's right, man. Just get the job done. Here we go now. 6.5 minutes. It is first down and 20 after the penalty. Aggie show a little pressure, back out of it. Franklin.
Harris.
A little bit too low to Washington.
Yeah, Devontae Harris baiting James Franklin a bit there. Sitting back in coverage, sitting back. Then he read the route by Washington, and then he just jumped it. Step or two quicker, and he's able to step in front of that ball that was thrown late in the flat and take it the other way for a touchdown.
Dangerous situation here for the Tigers. Second down and 20 now. 6.5 minutes on their own 22-yard line. Franklin steps up middle. Lucas could not hang on. Matthews with good coverage.
Sure was, Brent. And it looked like a clean hit in a season where there have been a lot of controversial hits. You know, where you have targeting and a player using the crown of his helmet. This is a clean hit by Howard Matthews. You could tell that he's adjusted his way of making that play. Lowers his shoulder right into Marcus Lucas and just in the nick of time.
Third down and 20. Near side, and it was caught by Bud Sasser, his first catch of the night. They pick up a few more yards before they punt here.
Yeah, if nothing else, that it can affect field position. Their punter has done a marvelous job tonight of pinning A&M back. Four of his punts inside the 15-yard line already tonight. So if anything, if nothing else, they did affect the field position.
Christian Brinzer into punt. And Labhart goes back. The sure-handed one is back there now. There is the fair catch, and he'll make the catch at the 10-yard line. Johnny Manziel, the reigning Heisman Trophy winner, 90 yards away from possibly sending South Carolina to Atlanta. Come on back. tied at 21. And Herbie, let's take a look at how the Aggies are finding success tonight on the ground. Brought to you by Expedia.
Well, they knew coming in they had to be able to run the football. The last 2 weeks, they've only averaged 3.2 yards a carry against Mississippi State and LSU. So they were committed to getting back to being able to run the ball. And it's been a committee of backs. And we've seen them all. We've seen Molina, Brandon Williams, Trey Carson, Trey Williams. They've all had their chances to be able to help this Aggies offense out. And they've been much more balanced tonight. 184 yards on the ground, 192 through the air.
Brandon Williams, the running back. They pitch it to the outside, and Labhart, a sure-handed one. Labhart now with seven catches. He's the leading receiver in this game for the Aggies.
And again, can't say enough about his growth in this offense. They said that one thing was unique about him, most of their receivers were in one position. Labhart has learned all the positions coming into this year. That's why he had a chance to play so much.
Second down and one. Running play is blown up that time. Nothing doing for Brandon Williams. And that big Mike linebacker, Andrew Wilson, in there.
When the Aggies run the ball, you got to deal with Andrew Wilson. But really, the boys up front did a great job of holding up. And that cleared things up for Wilson to be able to make that play.
Now can this defensive line get a rush? Third down and four. Four down. Manziel moves to the right, incomplete. Three and out. Gaines again all over Evans. What a night for Gaines.
Yeah, Mike Evans has got to be able to get some separation. Gaines is a great player. The ball's a little bit late because Johnny's running for his life to try to get some time. But big Mike Evans, you've seen him make that catch before, even though that ball was high from Johnny Manziel.
Kazer's the punter, but Marcus Murphy can give the Tigers outstanding field position inside of the five-minute mark. He is standing at the Tiger 40. It's off the side of the foot. Takes an Aggie bounce before it goes out of bounds. It'll be first down at about the 34-yard line. Well, tradition's found a new home. The most storied conference in college athletics will live on a new network, the SEC Network, launching August of next year. For more information, go to getsecnetwork.com. And, of course, the Auburn Tigers await either Missouri or South Carolina. Again, Tigers win and they're in. They'll go to Atlanta to play for the SEC Championship. It is one of the most unbelievable stories of the year in college football, that Auburn and Missouri are still alive in the battle to play for a conference championship after the years that they experienced last year. James Franklin for 47, first down and 10 of a tie game. Josie's a running back. Josie breaks on through. Picked up 4 or 5 yards on first down. Pinkel would love to kill the clock here.
Yeah,
just drive it on down and win it.
That's right. And again, that was their strength to start this second half, was the guys up front and the running of Henry Josie. Kind of gotten away from that a little bit.
Second down and six. Franklin going to pick his way. Look kind of a screen, like he was going to hand it to him.
It sure did.
He decided to go over to that side, didn't it?
It sure did. Looks like he was a little bit of a delayed reaction. But this is survival of the fittest to a certain degree. Before it maybe comes down to field goal kicking, it's who's going to win that battle up front to give the quarterback a chance or give these linebackers a chance to scrape and make plays.
Somewhere Nick Saban is saying, forget those field goals. Keep driving. Third down and one. There's Josie, got the first down, breaks free, midfield, foot race for the end zone, 20, 10, hello, touchdown. A 57-yard lightning bolt by a young man you find yourself pulling hard for. Henry Josie returning to football after major, major knee surgery on the left knee. Oh.
extra point is good. Johnny Football is under the gun. 3:34. Needs a touchdown to tie the Josie game. South Carolina win. Got it. That's all I need to know. Forget it, George. I got it. We welcome you back now. This is the Lightning Bolt.
And what a great job by the right side. Look at this wall that's created by the right side of the offensive line. Mitch Morse with the big block, the right tackle. Effort there by Honeycutt to make a play, but it started up front. We talked about Missouri going back to their strength where they started the second half getting physical up front. There's a reaction on the sideline from A&M's leader, Johnny Manziel.
You mentioned Mitch Morse. His grandmother was once a secretary for Barry Switzer down at Oklahoma. Here we go now.
He'd be proud of that block, that's
indeed.
For sure.
Indeed. Molina and Williams back deep for the Aggies. Here comes Williams. And he is out of bounds at about the 27-yard line. The SEC West has been decided, but not the East. Missouri wins, they'll play Auburn. Missouri loses, South Carolina goes to Atlanta. Very simple.
Now that we showed that shot at Johnny Manziel. You know, they're not in the mix to win the SEC East or West, anything for that matter. They're trying to get to a good bowl game. But you're a competitor. This is what it comes down to. You're down 7, 3:27 to go. You got all three timeouts. You saw his emotion on the sideline. The ball's in his court. Let's see what he can do here to try to get the Aggies back in this game.
Carson, the running back. Carson bolts to the 30, shakes off a tackler, but not the three who gang tackle him.
There's a big-time collision there with Trey Carson, and you know who was right in the middle of it is Andrew Wilson. The time at this point is not a factor at all for Manziel and the Aggies. It's all about trying to just move the chains to try to create some tempo and get this Missouri defense on its heels.
Second and 7. Manziel trying to find somebody open. Has to throw the ball away. Here comes 3rd and 7. Manziel down a touchdown. Pressure coming that time from Lucas Vincent.
You see that frustration? It's not just about the pressure. It's about the wide receivers in their routes. He's looking around. Nobody outside of Travis Labhart is running routes to get open, to get separation. The guy's getting pressure. Somebody's got to try to help him out.
5 receivers on this 3rd and 7. Drops it off to the short man, and nothing. Evans breaks away, breaks a tackle, and then is taken down by about 4 Tigers.
When a little thing, you want to talk about the importance of accuracy? Look where this football is on his back shoulder instead of in front of him. See how it's behind him? It didn't allow him to catch the ball and keep his momentum going forward. He had to go back, which slowed him down, and he doesn't have the quickness out in space to be able to make a play when the ball is thrown behind him.
And with 2:16 and the clock running, Aggies are forced to punt. Kazer will punt. Murphy back deep.
Looks like A&M may have used one of those timeouts.
First timeout this half. This is a 30-second timeout.
And Herbie, that'll give us a chance to look at this week's BCS standings brought to you by Tostitos. And what a shakeup we're going to have. Alabama goes down. Florida undoubtedly will jump to 1. And then let the battle begin for number 2. Ohio State able to hang on as Michigan goes for the win rather than overtime. And then you've got the Auburn Tigers and that big win. They are now very much in the mix. Missouri with a win today. They are in the argument. It'll be fun to sort this all out tomorrow. Look forward to watching my man Herbie, Maurice Davis. You guys will
sort it all out in that BCS show tomorrow
night.
I'll slip away from the Giants and the Redskins. I'll be watching you, man.
It'll be a lot of, I mean, this is the last year of the BCS, and how fitting to have one of the wackiest, crazy finishes that we've had down the stretch here in the last week, next week of the season.
BCS chaos, baby.
There you go.
Murphy going to let this one go. And there was a player from Missouri who got close to the ball. He may have been touched by it. And if so, this was some alert recovery here.
Yeah.
Ponder is over there with his teammate. I couldn't tell for sure up here.
It took a strange hop when it landed near him. Yeah, he's yelling, Peter, clear out. I don't know if it touched him or not.
It didn't. But no. This one, watch here now. This one Mizzou player, he's not going to take a chance.
Took a strange hop.
Yes, it did.
He saw it. Murphy just took off.
Murphy goes after it.
Just to be safe, he went after that football. So A&M's got only two timeouts now with the 2:01 to go. They used one, which was interesting there, before they punted it away.
Missouri, 2 minutes away from Atlanta. Josie in as the running back. Josie. And you know, Missouri picked up even more credibility tonight when South Carolina, the only team to beat them in the SEC, went in and beat Clemson. They were in Columbia. That game was a home game for South Carolina. But that just adds to the whole thing here for Missouri.
Resume, yeah, and how about this? They're up 17 in the second half, fourth quarter, to a team that, you know, if they make a kick here or there, Missouri's undefeated, and they're right in the thick of this thing.
Absolutely. And in the second overtime, remember the tying field goal hit the left upright. Boink.
Yeah, that was kind of one of those crazy finishes, especially when you're playing at home here in Columbia. But can't say enough about Gary Pink on the job that he and his staff have done. Second year in the SEC. Last year, of course, lost James Franklin for a number of games. Lost five of their top seven offensive linemen. And I got to tell you, around the SEC, kind of became a little bit of a laughing stock. Oh, Missouri in the big boy conference now. I think they took it personally. In fact, Gary told us this week, first time in 9 years they didn't make a bowl game. And they got together as a senior class and as a team in January, and they got committed. They became unified to get back to playing football and have a great year in 2013, and they sure have done that.
And, of course, Coach Pinkel lost his mentor, Don James, one-time great head coach out at the University of Washington. Died from pancreatic cancer. He gave Coach Pinkel so much good advice through the years. Little toss in underneath for a first down. And that's Waters. So Eric Waters with his first catch of the night after blocking on that offensive line with a huge play.
A&M sold out against the run. What a call by Josh Henson, the offensive coordinator. A little bit of a risk there, throwing the football when A&M only has the one timeout left. But he gets it into the hands of the big tight end, and he stays in bounds and keeps that clock moving.
A minute and a half away from Atlanta. And the amazing Auburn Tigers. And think about this now. Two incredible stories. Two teams that didn't go to bowl games last year are about to play for the SEC championship if Missouri can kill a minute 20 here. Here's a handoff. Hansborough, he's got another first down.
You know, you talk about Auburn and Missouri. They were combined 2-14 last year in conference play. Think about that. 2-14, and Gary Pinkel here in Columbia and Gus Malzahn down in Auburn are on their way to match up in Atlanta.
Now look at that blood on my man there. Do you see Max Copeland?
There he is.
Now that's an offensive lineman. You see that?
There
that little scab, you know, comes here. You see that.
I love it.
A minute away, folks. The zoo is rocking. This is so big for Missouri graduates everywhere. We've got John Walsh back at ESPN. He graduated from the journalism school here. I know how excited he has been about the team's performance this year.
No doubt.
And for so many alums, St. Louis, Kansas City,
Dallas,
all around the country.
Dallas, they're everywhere. And they have so much pride, you know, like everybody does for their school. But after the year that they had last year, they're kind of getting the last laugh in the SEC by getting to Atlanta.
Oh, man, does this victory formation feel good. And at Williams-Brice, the South Carolina fans, after experiencing a big win over their arch rival, and they were watching the conclusion of our game up on the Jumbotron, they will now file out of the stadium and await and see which bowl game South Carolina will be going to. There's a big, big bowl spot out there, and some argument now. Alabama, of course, is in the mix.
This may be James Franklin's favorite snap of his entire career right here.
It's Mizzou, folks. What's the comeback of the year story? Is it Auburn or is it Mizzou? Take your choice. They'll play next week for an SEC championship. A gutty performance here tonight, coming from behind. The fireworks explode over Perot Field. Columbia is ready to party. The fans were told not to storm the field. Good luck with that. 28-21 for Kirk Herbstreit. We traveled all the way up here from Auburn. Heather Cox and our entire crew. I'm Brett Musburger. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Coming up in 15 seconds, stay tuned for SportsCenter.